Israel has every right to defend itself.
Look,
even if it's, it means
killing children, yeah.
You're not letting me.
That was the whole point I was making.
No, give me a minute to answer.
Okay, go on.
Will you?
Go on.
Hamas hides their rockets under hospitals. What choice do we have?
How do you know they hide under the hospitals? Because somebody told you.
Intelligence.
Exactly, they told you, right? So it's their story against them. The reason I emphasize on children is because this is also in your book, which you consider to be the holy book. You know the first five books?
Yeah.
In the book of Numbers. Yes, Numbers 31, 17, 18. It says clearly that Moses was instructed by your God. Yes, the reason I say your God is because it's a biblical narrative, the biblical God commanded Moses to kill every male, every female, every child, and to save only those females or those girls who have not slept with other men. In other words, all the virgins should be saved. Everyone else should be killed. Even the little boys who are not female, they should be massacred. And these are children. So this is something which is in your book. But you will not find innocent children. Let me finish. You will not find in the Quran innocent children being specifically targeted to be killed. But in the Bible or in the Old Testament, which is your book, the first five books, which you say is something which is a holy book to you, this is there. Now, how do you reconcile that with the real life scenario that you see in Israel, where there's no problem killing children?
What are you talking about? Are the Amalekim?
Yeah.
Amalekim are a tribe?
Not the Amalekites. I'm talking about the ones which are the Midianites.
Midianites, there are seven tribes that God told us, ordered us to kill them.
Even the children?
Even the children.
Would you do that?
Yeah, I would do that.
You would kill children? Yeah. Oh, you got baby killers here.
La, if God ordered me...
That is what it is. Okay. Stop pushing me. I'm not a baby.
Let me answer you. Okay. But if God ordered me something, I will do it. I'm not questioning God.
But how do you know
God? Maybe you question God. I don't.
How do you know God's talking to you?
I am a slave of God. I do whatever
you know. Says. You know, we are called Abdullah. Yes, the slaves of Allah. Yes, so yeah, we have the same concept.
That's only names.
No.
Actions.
Submission to Allah is in the Quran.
Actions.
Yeah, but the question is this. Listen. If God is most just, most merciful, yes? Listen. A just God, would he allow you to kill an innocent child?
God tells me what to do, not...
But how do you know it's God telling you in the book? The book might be written to take revenge. You know why I say revenge? Because that is exactly the reason that is given in that book.
I'm not judging God. You'll not make me to judge God.
I'm not asking you to judge God. I'm asking you.
Listen, there is a problem here. Let me just emphasize on something here. You mentioned something important about, for example, killing. He said, if God told me to kill babies, I will do it. What if God told you, let's say, according to the Bible, if there is something according to your scriptures, if God told you, you know, don't worship me, worship someone else. That means it's definitely not the word of God. It is definitely is not the word of God. Because what God will never, ever telling you to worship someone else.
You're doing the same.
Hold on a second.
I'm just using this.
So if God is just, and he commands only justice, yeah? So he will never, ever tell you to kill an innocent baby. Will never, ever tell you to do
defenseless babies, come on.